Day there, very good morning. You're watching Proactive London. IXICO earnings and revenues, they rose amid expanding orders. We've got the CEO Giulio Cerroni joining us here today. A very good morning to you, because you did indeed have your interim results published today for the period to March 2021, indicating a strong set of financial results for IXICO. Maybe take us through the highlights, and a very good morning to you, Giulio.
Yes, good morning. And of course, so I'm delighted there was a very strong performance across the P&L. At a commercial level, revenues grew by 8% to 4.9 million in the period. And the order book remains strong following a lot of new contracts valued around about £9.4 million in the period. So in addition to the top line growth, we also saw a significant improvement in our EBITDA, which improved by 30% to 0.9 million for the period, up from 0.7 million last year. I should say also, I'm very pleased with the further accretion in the gross margins that we saw, which went to 67.6%, which benefited from a favorable contract mix, but also from the improvement and productivity initiatives that we implemented about a year ago. So, Scott, we're going into the second half of the year with a very strong order book, EBITDA margin of about 18% and a cash position of 7%, and continue to be debt-free.
And you mentioned the order book a few times there, so let's maybe talk about that, because we want to find out what was in those orders, because I know you recently had a recent flurry of new contract wins announced.
Yes, so actually you'll also recall that in April, on April 26th, we gave a trading update, and we announced that we were actually removing 7.1 million from the order book through to 2024. And that reflected the de-scoping of our largest client, Huntington's Pivotal and Open Label Extension Studies. So despite that significant headwind, I'm delighted to say that the 9.4 million of new contracts that have been awarded have really meant that now we have a very strong book-to-bill ratio of about 1.9, which is very healthy. And that provides us with a very good visibility for future period with an order book at the end of the period of £19 million. And so that's a great position to be in. And I'm delighted that, to be in that position, because obviously we previously also highlighted that, you know, a repercussion for the industry of COVID-19 was that the number of new trials being instigated were slowing down. Actually, we saw quite a significant reduction in the last 12 months. And obviously, you know, IXICO isn't immune to those things, but we definitely start to see some green shoots of recovery. And that's obviously substantiated by the £9.4 million in new contracts across those multiple contracts clients. But also pleased to see that's carried on into the next period. And we've just recently announced an additional three contracts worth around about £2 million as well. So, we're pleased with that momentum, and we'll obviously continue to want to carry on in that vein going forward into the second half of the year.
Tell us about the strategy to build your pipeline in the current challenging COVID-19 business environment.
Sure. So 4 years ago, I set out a five-point growth strategy for IXICO, and our success has really been as derived from that strategy. It's a commercially-led growth strategy that's really underpinned by a strong commitment to innovation and building a strong client company culture. So specifically in relation to the pipeline, our strategy is to target early phase and be ready for late phase. This is a long-term play which maximizes IXICO's core capability of commercializing innovation quicker than bigger but, you know, slower competitors in this particular area. We see that's key to our success. Now, of course, we also want to be reinvesting profits from the business to, as I said, be ready for that longer term play in scaling the business to be ready for those larger trials that when they do come, very significant and would be actually additional growth trajectory for the business. So what we're seeing in our pipeline, and this is all coming through, we see that around about 60% of our current pipeline is from early stage clinical trials, and that proportion is growing. So we're pleased with that, because in addition to embedding our technology into those clients, it also positions us well for those larger phase studies in 2, 3, 4 years time as the asset goes through the clinical development pipeline.
And you've spoken about that organic success growth that IXICO has achieved there. Any updates regarding M&A?
So I normally don't say too much about M&A because we've been very focused, as you say, to drive the organic growth plan because we're most in control of that, of course. And of course, you're right to highlight that, we've done a great job growing the business organically. And the growth we've seen in the past 4 years has been 100% organic. And to put it into context, for the full year 2016, our full year revenues were 3.1 million. And we've just reported 4.9 million for the first 6 months of this year. So, however, going forwards, we see that we've seen actually the fact that we've got a very technology-based platform has really helped us deliver the results we've delivered, demonstrated resilience, and really, as we see the trend towards more use of technology, more decentralized clinical trial protocols being adopted by the industry, we are interested in looking at partnerships and M&A that enhance our offering with complementary technologies for CNS clinical trials so that we can service more of this growing market. So as the fifth point of the growth strategy I mentioned right at the beginning, we do see that now as becoming more significant in the next 4 to 5 years. As a business, we're very well capitalized, and so we definitely want to make those things happen if we do find the right partnerships and M&A, given that we're well-resourced and well-capitalized and we have a very supportive institutional investor base to support us in the next phase of the company's growth.
Giulio Cerroni, thank you very much from IXICO this morning here on Proactive London.
Thank you very much.